One of the most common questions we get when we talk about genetics with patients and mutations is, how's that going to affect me, my family, insurability? And the simple answer is there's federal and state laws all over the place that protect patients against genetic discrimination. The first civil rights legislation of the 21st century was GINA's law, signed by Bush, that prevents discrimination against patients with a genetic mutation. All at the state level, there's laws to prevent that. Obamacare, actually, one of the few good things about it, in my opinion, is that it has expanded access to risk preventive genetic testing. So the concerns are out there, but they're not real in real life. I think the only real one might be with life insurance, because they have a right to look at your risk profile and base your insurance premiums based on that. So whether you do genetic testing or not, if you have a family history, they're going to ask about it. Understanding disease predisposition is something that insurance companies actually like to do. Believe it or not, they actually like to pay for genetic testing because they like to identify people at risk, not to let them go, but actually let them have risk reduction surgery, because paying for cancer treatment is far, far, far more expensive than paying for risk reduction surgery. So that is why almost all insurance companies will pay for genetic counseling and testing in the appropriate individual, because it makes economic sense for them, and of course it makes good sense for the patients and their welfare. So there is no downside, in my opinion, from that point of view. I think ignorance in the sense of just not knowing and understanding is really what pushes people towards not getting genetic counseling and testing. But once you fully understand what's at stake and understand the laws and understand what it's all about, there are few good excuses not to get genetic counseling and testing. I think the valid ones are psychological. If someone just can't deal with that at a certain point in their life, or is afraid, I think that's a valid reason. But usually with good genetic counseling and explaining things in common sense terms, who wouldn't want to know if they're at risk? If you see a child in the street and there's a car coming their way, wouldn't you want to get them out of the way of an oncoming car? I mean, in many ways, genetics and cancer prevention is the same way. Why would you want to turn away from the risk, and why would you want to expose yourself to potential harm? So if you break it down into simple common sense, most people will eventually embrace it, but it should be done at the patient's time and discretion. It should never be forced on them. They should never be pressured for it. I think the one ethical problem is, say, a mother is at risk and should be tested, and her daughter wants to know for her sake, but the mother doesn't want to test. What is her moral and ethical obligation to her daughter? That's a personal question. There's certainly no legal obligation to test for the sake of other family members, but I think there is a moral and ethical obligation that if your physician says you may be at risk and the genetic information may impact others in your family, that maybe you do have a moral and ethical obligation to do that for your family. And even if you don't like your family members, I think you still should do it.
Do you know that not every breast cancer patient needs chemotherapy? Now there's a way to decide if chemotherapy will benefit you based on the unique biology of your tumor. To learn more about the Oncotype DX test and how to discuss it with your doctor, click this button.